NFL Primetime is presented by Miller Lite. Primetime is Miller time. And now, here's your host, Chris Berman.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Week 14 of NFL Primetime. Chris Berman along with Tom Jackson, December 7th. And in this 2003 season, I cannot remember a Sunday, Tom, with so many 1-2 teams, five of the eight divisions, all four in the AFC going head-to-head. It really was a showdown Sunday.
Yeah, and I think that we knew we were going to have some things decided by the time we got to this primetime.
And some of the showdowns weren't quite showdowns. You know what? We're going to start with the two teams that made the Super Bowl last year, and they're not in any of these big games. Why is that? Here we go with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and John Gruden. Just trying to stay mathematically alive at the Saints, a team that beat them both times last year, not to mention this year. Look at the headless horseman, Deuce McAllister, hit by John Lynch, loses the helmet, but does not get his 10th straight 100-yard game, so his streak is ended at 9, third longest in NFL history. David Gibson blocks the punt of Mitch Hamburger. Rondé Barber picks it up. And the Bucs are in position to score two touchdowns inside the two-minute warning of the first half after they trailed 7-0. And it's Warren Sapp who actually makes a hell of a catch. Look at the big guy. Grab it, fall, 14-7 Bucs. And I mean, that was pretty much it. The Bucs got those lightning touchdowns right there. Deuce ended up with 69. The Saints fans didn't know what to do. They were going LSU off of yesterday's result. And once again, the Saints cannot win in December, and the Bucs, a little glimmer, although...
Yeah, but what a great run by Deuce McAllister, that 9 games in a row where he gained over 100 yards rushing.
So the Tampa Bay Bucs are 6-7, as are the New Orleans Saints. The first time this vaunted rivalry to the Raiders-Steelers, neither team was at least at 500. And in this game, it's Jerome Bettis, the Bus, passing Thurman Thomas, 9th on the all-time list. And he needs 5 more yards to pass Franco Harris for 8th on the all-time list. That should happen next week. 17-7 game. Raiders punting. And Antoine Randall had a couple of big receptions, had one return, and then had this one. Whoop! And then he turns on the Jets. It would be a 51-yard return, almost going all the way, setting up a Kreider touchdown. And the Steelers beat the Raiders 27-7. So Pittsburgh's 5-8. The Raiders, they weren't as dumb a team this time. They only got 5 penalties, Tom, but they lose 27-7. They get only 9 first downs. Meyer throws for only 68 yards. And boy, just a year ago, it was Bucks who are still alive, but, you know, barely. And the Raiders, who were gone a long time ago. It shows you what a fine line we have this day and age.
Yeah, I think we're seeing the line of parity being marked by the past 2 Super Bowl teams, and we only have to go back the previous year before that to see 2 Super Bowl participants miss the playoffs the next year. So I think, you know, you get that one shot or 2 shots, you get your chance, you either win that game, win the Super Bowl, or maybe the next year you might not be in the playoffs.
The Patriots didn't make it last year, neither did the Rams. The Patriots had at least, you know, a shot at it.
Yeah, Bucks not mathematically.
Teams, yeah, these teams really showing that on the Raiders, they're not showing that gumption whatsoever.
Yeah, I'm really concerned about that.
That was the immaculate deception in this game. I know you were. When we return, we get into the showdown games. One involved Marvin Harrison and the Colts as they went head-to-head with Tennessee. Many a big catch, and of course, Marvin had some. And would this be the day that Bruce Smith would set the records for most sacks lifetime, Skins and Giants?
We must protect this house!
NFL Primetime, presented by Miller Lite. Grab yourself a great-tasting, low-carb Miller Lite. And in part by Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be.
Here we go, the Chargers and the Lions. The Lions had won 3 in a row at home, but you know what? We forget because the Chargers have had such a, frankly, a sorry season. How good a player LaDainian Tomlinson is. Look at Doug Flutie rolling right, and then only Dougie does this. He flings it back to Tomlinson, and it's a 16-yard touchdown. Now, with the same score, 7-0, second quarter now, Flutie using Tomlinson as a receiver today, and look at him go. Bing, down the seam, 73 yards, and my favorite part of the play, Tom, and yours to watch this. In the end zone, where's the official? Here's the ball.
Hand it back.
Here's the ball. And the Chargers beat the Lions 14-7. Tomlinson today caught 9 for 148. That's a high in receiving for a running back this year. And the only thing, if the Lions had tied this game, the only thing better than a Chargers-Lions game would have been a Chargers-Lions game in overtime. Harrington had a chance at the end. But San Diego gets their third win of the year. Detroit falls to 4-9. Tomlinson receiving and rushing at 236 yards, Tom. Washington at the New York Giants. A lot of Giant fans have been frozen in their seats all year, but at least they have a brewski. 7-3 Giants second quarter, Tim Hasselbeck. Darnarian McCann's touchdown skins. But the story of this day, Bruce Smith, tied with Reggie White for most sacks lifetime. Now he takes Kerry Collins out of the game. Not that he was intending to do that. No sack. Sprained ankle x-rays negative. Enter Jesse Palmer. And Smith, Tommy, thinks he gets him here, right?
Yeah, he got very close. And you're going to see the frustration right there. Bruce says, boy, that was almost it.
But in the fourth quarter with the score 20-7, Jesse Palmer might as well face it. You're addicted to sacks. Career sack number 199 for Bruce Smith. First all time, and here's the move.
Yeah, technically, what a great move. You see the overarm. He comes underneath right there and just kind of falls into that sack. And you can see right there, boy, that's a career's worth of celebration.
Boy, that quick move was the patent of Bruce Smith with all those years of the Buffalo Bills. And Palmer now becomes the 74th different quarterback of those 199 sacks for Bruce Smith. Congratulations to the big guy, 40 years young, as the Redskins win 20-7 and the New York Giants have lost five straight games. There was Bruce as a Buffalo Bill. We told you he got 74 different quarterbacks, 199 in all, passing Reggie White. Of course, they only started keeping track of these things since 82, and Bruce and Reggie have all said, well, we're only loaning this from Deacon Jones. But congratulations, Bruce Smith.
Inside the Numbers, brought to you by Visa. If you love the NFL, it's everywhere you want to be.
Of course, I've been on loan or borrowing, but you know what I mean. Peyton Manning against Steve McNair, one of the big matchups of today, and they may play for a third time. Who knows? Meanwhile, in the AFC East, the weather outside, frightful in New England. 2 feet of snow. Tom Brady in the snow. Have we seen this before? Patriots versus Dolphins.
Get everybody in the country to drive the all-new Chevy Malibu, we think you'd agree, it's just about perfect.
The new Chevy Malibu, available with OnStar. Visit ChevyMalibu.com for details.
Disciplined investing. At T. Rowe Price, it's not just about the short term. It's about a steady, long-term approach. Over 75% of our mutual funds beat their 3, 5, and 10-year Lipper averages. A disciplined, long-term approach. Low-cost mutual funds from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence.
They are ghosts of the gridiron. Their names are legend, and their time has come again. Now, a new generation has emerged as college football's celebration of excellence writes a new chapter. Who will be the chosen few? The 2003 Heisman Trophy presentation presented by Wendy's, Saturday at 8 Eastern on ESPN.
I moved to Earthlink because I only want the internet that's good for my kids.
Because I like being...
Speed, security, control. Your reasons are your own. Call, go online, or visit these retailers and get 6 months of dial-up service featuring Earthlink Accelerator at half price. Move to Earthlink. It revolves around you.
Monday Night Football playoff hopeful Carolina in Atlanta to face a Falcon team that's been woeful as far as record is concerned. But you talk about a ray of hope. Mike Vick making his first start of the season. How would he look? Would the Falcons be different? For highlights, John Anderson.
Panthers, Falcons, welcome back to the huddle. Michael Vick, first start of the year, Atlanta 2-9 in his absence.
Number 7, Michael Vick.
They like him. On the other side, Michael Rucker. Mic'd up, take a listen.
Oh, Gosh dang it.
That's all right. Rub it out. Rucker gets back in there.
Hey, and I got some of them too. I'm back. You can't stop me.
A lot of noise being talked later in the first. We're tied at 7. Michael Vick, the boys are set. This is Michael Vick being special, which is what he does. It led to a field goal by Jay Feely, which he missed from 34 yards. And then in the fourth quarter, 14-7, Panthers, Vick again. This time he's extra special. Munching up the turf, just running everywhere. Oh, the defense, they're going to be winded. Now everybody in the NFL, especially on the defensive side, is just crazed because this guy is back and he's fantastic. Same drive, second and goal, little play action fake. Vic, I'll take that, thanks. 141 rushing yards, house. Tie game at 14. 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Vic, up top now, besides the ground, 179 passing yards. That's a total of 320. The other team had 231. He's good. Same drive, Vic, though. Here's a hiccup. Looking for Algie Crumpler again and doesn't get him. Deion Grant picks it off. Look at Algie. He fought for it, though, but we're going to overtime. Panthers 3-0 in OT this season, all on the road. 3rd-and-3 in the extra time. Jake DeLome, pick. Kevin Mathis going to the house. 32 yards for the touchdown. Going to be close. Ball in before knee down. Ref says, yeah, 2014. Falcons win. Next week on ESPN Sunday Night Football, the Giants and Saints from New Orleans. Saints clinging to a playoff dream. The G-men need a win just to make the holidays happy. Won't be easy in the Big Easy. Saints-Giants Sunday Night Football. Now back to Boomer.
The Texans and the Jaguars. Some of the first two quarterbacks hurt for the Dallas Texans. The lefty, Dave Ragone from Mobile. Start for David Carr. They're also without Dominic Davis. And, boy, they look that way. Meanwhile, Byron Leftwich, the rookie for Jacksonville, to Jimmy Smith, 32 yards. Jags lead 7-0. Then Fred Taylor, 2-yard touchdown, 17-0 Jags at the half. Then more Fred Taylor. And let's face it, he can do this.
Yes, absolutely.
Right? I mean, Fred Taylor, again, we talked about a guy like LaDainian Tomlinson on a tough team. Fred Taylor.
Great vision for the cutback lane, which you see him spot all the time, and he's always had extraordinary speed, as good as any back in the league.
And so on this day, the Jaguars do that. Jacksonville wins it 27-0, so they've won two inside of a week with that big game against Tampa. They only allowed the Texans 124 yards, second lowest in their brief history, and so at Jacksonville, a big winner. Jets at the Bills, both teams won at the Meadowlands last week. Boy, the Jets look different with Chad Pennington, but the Bills look different. This was their plan all year, Tom. Mm-hmm. Travis Henry to run the ball. And Buffalo leading in the third quarter after that touchdown, 14-3. With the score 14-6, Henry a 14-yard run. And then this is Henry who runs tough. You know, he played hurt a lot of the year. The line has not had a great year, but he can be like this.
Yeah, when he is healthy, you see him run bigger than he is. He's able to overpower people once he gets through the line, and that will set up play-action pass for them.
And that set up a field goal. Meanwhile, Pennington is picked off by Terrence McGee. Me and Terrence McGee. And Herm not happy on this one as the Bills. Well, now the Bills, you know, hey, the Bills have won a couple in a row here, circling one wagon at a time. And despite only 9 of 15 passing from Drew Bledsoe, a career high for Travis Henry, 169 yards. Buffalo is the team that's 6-7. They also had 5 sacks today, their defense.
Yeah, defense playing well. And we said this time of year, said it this morning on Countdown, now we want that running game to really take hold of our offensive game plan.
And a lot of things swirling about the future of the coaching staff. You know, the Bills might go on a roll here at the end of the year and change a lot of things. Randy Moss and the Vikings trying to change a lot of things, like losing. Do they do it against the Seahawks? And with the oldest standing rivalry in the NFL, the Bears and the Packers at Lambeau Field. The Bears actually have clawed back into the Norris Division race. Brett Favre, 188 straight games, breaking the club record held by Hall of Famer Forrest Gregg. Brett, this was like the early days of Brett Favre. Picked up by Lance Briggs, 45 yards, and the Bears have gone into Lambeau and lead it 14-0. A couple of Longwell field goals make it 14-6. And he hits Sterling, 84, Javon Walker, 22 yards, and Favre is back, 14-13. A minute 19 to go, and they have Cordell Stewart to the rookie, Justin Gage. Oh, man, they were Bears Bears would have been back on top by a touchdown.
What a great throw by Cordell Stewart. Gage just lets it slip right through his fingers.
And when you don't make those, then sometimes you make these. Mike McKenzie, one of the McKenzie brothers. Take off, you hoser. 90 yards, touchdown. And after the Pats spot the Bears, a 14-0 lead, Brett and the Pack beat Chicago 34-21. Favre, lifetime against the Bears, 20-4. McKenzie had two picks in the game. Azuma, by the way, the kickoff return for the Bears. For the Packers are 7-6 and in the hunt again, Tom.
Yeah, great sign for the Green Bay Packers. Armand Green, the 30 carries, so they had the balance. But Brett Favre, besides that pick that he threw, really was on target like the old Brett Favre before the thumb started to bother him.
Meanwhile, they were hoping that Minnesota would keep on losing. They're 1-5 in their last six. And they're hosting the Seattle Seahawks for the first time since 1984, since Chuck Knox beat Les Steckel. Les Steckel, more fun. Meanwhile, Dante Culpepper, what is this bomb? 47 yards to Randy Moss. It's a touchdown between two defenders and under the hefty bag.
And remember Willie Mays, because that's Willie Mays. Like, right. He kept the hands down around the waistline, made the over-the-head catch.
You know, some people want to watch rugby on a Sunday afternoon. This is part of NFL primetime service. Maurice Morris on the scrum. This is a kick return. rumbling, stumbling, and 85 guys make the tackle in the scrum. Meanwhile, 13-7 Vikings third quarter. Culpepper. Moss, touchdown. Culpepper, no, it's not a legal procedure. And you've heard of the Lambeau Leap? The Viking vault. Moss, a pair of touchdowns. Matt Hasselbeck to Bobby Engram. Seattle trying to get something going. He is womp, and we only show this hit by Brian Russell and Engram. He's okay. Otherwise, we wouldn't show this, but wow. Kept ticking. Left with a concussion, but he was all right. Went home with the team, we understand. Hasselbeck late in the game, picked off by Mike Nateel. This the early season Vikings. He could go all the way. Minnesota with three bombs, two of them to Moss. Minnesota with three turnovers to none, one for a touchdown. This is how they won their first six games, and this is how they got to 8-5, dropping Seattle, who's 1-5 on the road, to 8-5.
Yeah, and control of this football game defensively also, besides the turnovers, we said they had to control. Sean Alexander, 56 yards, 14 carries. That qualifies as control.
The Vikings had the ball 39 minutes in that game. Cardinals, 49ers. Jeff Garcia, Niners, humble on the road. At home, another story. Terrell Owens touchdown, and then it's the mime touchdown react. Oh yeah, Charlie Marcel Marceau. Hello, bonjour. Niners lead 34-0. You want to know how the Cardinals game went? What the heck was that? Flags. It's a lateral. He threw it off the face of his offensive lineman. Marcel Shipp falls on it. It's a safety. That's Josh McCown, and dare I say, what? Garcia. Meanwhile. Threw four touchdown passes, ran for two, only the third quarterback ever to do that, along with Bill Kinney and Eric Hipple. What is Hipple? And then Kevin Barlow had 154 yards. The Cardinals should be, they're a joke. On the road, they're a joke.
I think they could get into BCS, though.
Well, I don't think they'd be in the big bowl game, though. I don't know, then USC might be in the Rose Bowl. 50-14, the 49ers humble the Cards. We're 0-7 on the road this year. Of course, San Francisco heads back out on the road next week, which is always an adventure. But at home, they've had some of the biggest blowouts of the entire season. When we return, the big games of the day. Showdown Sunday.
Frost and 7-5, you know, hanging from a string from Mike Shanahan. Sucking on his behind all the time. You know, when you're scared, you're scared. And this weekend, y'all can quote me, y'all can do what y'all want to, but we're going to put something on that, and you can believe that.
That was this week, Eddie Kennison, one time, obviously not current Bronco wide receiver, playing for the Kansas City Chiefs, who beat Denver earlier this year 24-23 in a game, which both teams came into at 4-0. KC, you know, has been off and running since. Denver struggled since that point, 3-5, starting with that loss. But today it was in Denver, and how could we go at Mile High? In Visco Field at Mile High, and Mike Shanahan and the Broncos trying to stay in the playoff hunt and trying to stave off the 11-1 Chiefs. What do? You give it to Clinton Portis. 11-yard touchdown, made it 7-0, 5.5 minutes into the game. Priest Holmes answers, 2-yard run, and Priest had 2 today. We're tied at 7. So we go that way to the second quarter. And when you're running with Portis, Jake Plummer can do this. Rod Smith's had a heck of a season, 15 yards. And then Portis, touchdown. That is a touchdown, 1 yard, 14-7 Denver. Dante Hall won the first meeting with his 93-yard punt return. He hadn't returned one since that point. He almost breaks it here. Tackled after 61 yards. Chief coaches say he's at it again. Sets up a Holmes touchdown, 14 all. 17-14 Denver. Inside the 2-minute warning, Trent Green. And there's Eddie Kennison. So he did his part. 42-yard from Trent Green, Tom.
Yeah, we're going to take another look at it. And you're going to see Johnny Morton and Eddie Kennison run the route directly at safety Sam Brandon. He can pick one of the two guys. He drops slightly to the outside. Eddie Kennison goes right inside the numbers, just splits the seam, and what a nice throw by Trent Green.
In the third, so now it's 21-17, but it's play action again for Denver with Jake Plummer. Seven had lost the Bears. You know, they've looked good with Plummer, that's for sure. That's Rod Smith, 14 yards. Play action to Reuben Drones. And the Broncos trying to drones the Chiefs' sorrows. 24-21, they have the lead. Third quarter, Portis busts up. Look at the move. He makes the midfield strike on Jerome Woods. He's Norwegian Woods. Gone.
Yeah, very reminiscent of Terrell Davis and what he used to do. Get on top of the safety, make the move inside, get to the end zone.
That was 59 yards, Tom, and this is Portis. He could go all the way. Standing 2 yards deep in the end zone, it's not really going to get that done. 4 touchdowns of the day for Portis, 38-21. And then, how about one more time? He's gone. 53-yard touchdown, Clinton Portis. 5 touchdowns, 218 yards rushing. And Clinton Portis has put his name on the books with 5 rushing touchdowns, 45-27, an amazing, amazing performance in this game by Portis.
Yeah, and you can skip the X's and the O's. What I wanted to say is that Mike Shanahan tends to get back at you with game plan. That is exactly what happened to the Kansas City Chiefs today.
Well, so the Broncos now alive, and we'll show you a little bit later, they're going to control their fate, believe it or not, and the Kansas City Chiefs, however, they are in the playoffs, right? That is correct. The Kansas City Chiefs, even with the loss, are in the playoffs, and Dick Vermeil is the 4th head coach. He joins Chuck Knox, Bill Parcells, Dan Reeves. Now, Dick Vermeil take 3 different teams to the playoffs, but not the way they wanted to get in back, and they still got a great record at 11-2. Meanwhile, Colts, Titans. Earlier this year was the Colts all over the Titans, a team that Tennessee had controlled. Here's Peyton Manning coming back to where he started, and Tennessee had not won yet. Here's our prime cut. And we go with the Colts and the Titans and Peyton Manning. Boy, they've leapt over a lot of hurdles, a lot of skeletons out of the closet, and Peyton would like to win at home, if you will, in Tennessee's college home. But Steve McNair's sneak makes it 10-3. Tennessee with the score 10-6. Marcus Washington falls into McNair's left leg as he throws a handoff to Chris Brown. Third down. Reason we show this look. 8 minutes to go in the half. Meanwhile, next Colts possession. Mike Vanderjagt, perfect all year. Had 5 today. 36 yards. Makes it 10-9. Eddie Berlin. Fumble! The Berlin Wall came down. The ball came down, Tom. And so the Colts pick it up. Vander, is he pretty good with this kick?
That's pretty straight.
That would have hit. That would have knocked the teacup off the middle of the uprights there. 12-10 at the half. Now, Hedger and James takes the handoff. And he scores on the first possession of the second half. 19-10 Colts. Ensuing kickoff. Eddie Berlin. Oh, man, he wants to go to East Berlin. It's a fumble. And so the Colts have the ball again. And then Vanderjagt kicks a field goal. And here's the point. Last 8 minutes of the second quarter, just about the first 8 minutes of the third quarter, Steve McNair has not touched the ball. What's that, Tom? 45
It's about 45 minutes in real time.
So now, 22-13, Colts late third. How about this catch by Marvin Harrison? Manning to Harrison, down to the 10.
Yeah, and we're going to take one more look at this. I want you to look inside Marvin Harrison's helmet. Watch the eyes. Look at the eyes. Follow the ball to the hand. great one-hand catch.
And so that would set up a James touchdown at 29-13. But now, down 16, how many times have you seen Steve McNair do this to Robert Holcomb? 9.5 minutes to go, touchdown. They get the two-point conversion. It's an eight-point game, 29-21, 2:20 to go. McNair, Justin McCarron's down to the two. McNair can't even walk. Can he pull off a comeback? McNair. How about this catch by Derek Mason after the two-minute warning? Touchdown, 29-27. They need another two-point conversion. McNair. Pass tip by defensive end Dwight Freeney.
And let's take another look. Dwight Freeney not rushing the passer. He's actually dropped off the line right there, following the quarterback's eyes. Great job of tipping the ball. May have saved the game for the Colts.
Yes, and Freeney, who's been their outstanding defensive player in his second year. And would you know, after Tennessee has a chance to get the ball back one more time, this time McCarron's returning the punt fumbles. And the Colts recover. And the Indianapolis Colts have swept the Tennessee Titans. They win by the count of 29-27. They have a one-game lead in the standings, but for all intents and purposes, a two-game lead because they will have swept the season series. Before this year, Tennessee had beaten Indianapolis 6 out of 7 times. After the game, the vanquished spoke about the comeback that almost was.
Justin was a guy that, you know, made some great plays today. Justin, you know, had some great catches offensively. And that one thing sits out in his mind. That's one thing that everybody's going to be talking about. But I got confidence in Justin. Everybody has confidence in Justin. Now, you know, if we, you know, look back, if we would have observed some things during the course of the ball game, maybe when it came down to it.
Down in the AFC North, no one could have predicted at the beginning of the year. Cincinnati and Baltimore, 7-5 each. Marvin Lewis was a defensive coordinator for Brian Billick when the Ravens won the Super Bowl. His team leading 3-0 with Peter Warwick. It's a fumble of the punt, and the Ravens recover. This would be a theme all day. Turnovers by Cincy deep in their own zone, and the Ravens made him pay for it. Jamal Lewis, touchdown, 7-3 Baltimore. Oh, by the way, did we tell you that the Ravens could play some defense? John Kitna can attest to that, Tom.
Yeah, you're going to watch Terrell Suggs come around the corner. Two mistakes here. Actually, Levi Jones does a pretty good job of driving him around the pocket. John Kitna starts to escape out of the pocket, doesn't settle, and gives him a chance to come from the backside to get the sack.
And then the next time inside the 20 goes Jamal Lewis with a 15-yard game. Same drive, second quarter, 3rd-and-1 at the 8. How it in the red blade? And it might have been the red tag. Anthony Wright and Marcus Robinson.
Where? It's like, what? Where's it been?
Montana to Rice? I mean, what? Whack. 14-3 Ravens. John Kitna, Peter Ward. Bengals making it a game, 14-10. Field goals each, 17-13 third quarter. But here's Suggs again, Tom. It's Kitna, it's a fumble. And it's a double play because Suggs makes the recovery. And then the Baltimore Ravens in business again, and you know they're going to the big fella.
Yeah, and what a weapon he is once you get inside the red zone. Here from the 18-yard line, he just runs over 3 or 4 tacklers, gets it down to the 3. Next play, you pitch it to Lewis off of the dive action by the fullback. Stiff arm right there on Brian Simmons, and he high steps it into the end zone.
And that was another one, Tom. They get the ball deep and they make him pay for it. The hand back to Lewis, and look at him here. 17-yard gain. Fourth quarter now, it's still a 24-13 game. And it's Lewis again. Hole up the middle. Boy, he runs hard and fast. 31-13 Ravens. 3 touchdowns, 180 yards for Jamal Lewis. He's over 1,600 for the year. And then Kitna hit by Marcus Douglas. Ray Lewis made about 3 big plays, but huge big plays. And, you know, 3rd and short, interception there. Marvin Lewis, you saw his ex-players go up and hug him. But on this day, the Bengals slipped a Mickey with their 3rd straight road game. The Ravens, their 3rd straight home game, too tough for them. Ravens made him pay every time they turned the ball over. 3 touchdowns off turnovers deep, 31-13 Baltimore. And after the game, Jaws with Ray Lewis.
Thank you very much. Ray, you talk about protecting the house. You're 6-1 at home right now. Why is it so important to win here?
It's hard, Ron. Man, our fans are incredible. when we come home and our defense is so loud, offense have a hard time playing against us. And this 12th man, man, it's just incredible. It's incredible playing in Baltimore.
How much fun is it to watch Jamal Lewis run the football like his when you're standing on the sideline?
I'm just happy I'm on his team. I wouldn't want to tackle that guy, man. It's truly a blessing just to watch him play.
All right, Ray, congratulations. Back to the studio.
All right, Johns, thank you. Tommy, when you get a Lewis on each side of the ball,
this just in. I like your chances.
Yeah, the Ray Lewis on defense is going to make some big plays, and the Lewis on offense, Jamal Lewis, is going to make some big plays, and he's going to be consistent. That was the key to the game offensively, was his running. That's our extra point. This is in the first quarter.
I won. Meanwhile, the Dallas Cowboys beat the Philadelphia Eagles earlier this year, and Bill Parcells, Donovan McNabb, before the big game, Eagles fired up. They've won seven in a row. Get Dallas, come into Philly, get a win, and get themselves in a tie for first. Well, Troy Hamburg ran 22 yards. Philly has not been great against the run this year. Dallas hasn't run well. We talked about it this morning. That a good run, though. And here's a big penalty. Third one, Ryan Young, false start.
Yeah, especially when Bill Parcells likes to run the ball into the end zone. He would rather run it than throw it.
And look at this. Looks like Young almost gets up, and Bill will not take that. So instead of a possible touchdown, it's a field goal. 3-3 second quarter. McNabb, the screen to Correll General Backhoffer. Clean, yet easy. 24 yards, first down, Philadelphia. Third and three, same drive. And what kind of godsend is Brian Westbrook from
Villanova?
Look at this. 1, 2, 3 Cowboys. He sheds them all. Touchdown.
And the last Cowboy, Roy Williams.
16-yard, the screen from McNabb, 10-3 Philly. Quincy Carter, the dump to Richie Anderson. He was effective for a while. First down, Cowboys. Carter, play action. The Jeff Swiss family Robinson. 3-yard touchdown. We're tied at 10, Tom. And how'd this play out?
Well, just watch how the play sets up. Robinson going to do a great job of selling the block right there. Watch the safety. Brian Dawkins is going to come down inside because he reads it as run. You slip off the block. Nice timing by on the part of the Dallas Cowboys.
And now we go third quarter, and some of the names you don't know for Philly stepping up large. Sheldon Brown, one of those DBs picked last year, with the pick of Carter down to the 27. That sets up. Boy, in the cold weather, why don't you try a shovel pass?
Yes.
The deuce is on the loose. McNabb to Staley, 5 yards, 17-10. Then Dallas at the all bad snap, and you might as well just get it out of there. Safety, 19-10. Philadelphia, now here come the Eagles.
Yeah, watch Deuce Staley in the backfield. He's not going to carry the football, but you ask why Philadelphia is winning, watch what he does here to protect the quarterback. That's why they're winning right there, because you're willing to do everything as a football team to help the guy who's lined up beside you.
Each one of those three backs does something better. This is the same drive, fourth quarter, and here's the rookie tight end, L.J. Smith. He's going to become more and more a part of the Eagles. Passing game, it's a touchdown, and now the route is on. 26-10, Akers field goal, 29-10, then Correll, General Buckhalter. He could go all the way, 64 yards. Philadelphia with over 400 yards on the number one ranked defense in football. Andy Reid's Eagles have now won 8 in a row, and Philly has beaten Dallas 36-10, essentially by doing the stepping on the neck of the Cowboys. Leading that division now by 2 games. And as we said, they haven't lost for 2 months. Donovan McNabb threw 3 touchdown passes, visited with Sal Palantonio.
Donovan made the playoffs 4 years in a row, tying a franchise record. What does that feel like?
Well, it feels great. That's the reason why you play this game, is obviously to be able to move on and move to the promised land, so to speak, and that's in Houston. But this is a big win for us. You know, 3 NFC champions back to back. Well, position, I should say, and we just have to continue to get better and better each week. It's exciting for us with everything that we've been through early in the year to be able to overcome that and to stay positive.
Well, stay positive indeed for Donovan McNabb.
Absolutely.
So the last 4 games now, Tom McNabb hit 9 different receivers, 10 different receivers, 9 different receivers, and today 8 different receivers.
You got it right, too. It's a plan. It's a plan. Everybody contributed.
And all 3 running backs doing something.
Absolutely.
And you showed Staley with the block. Buckhalter had the big game, and today's went Westbrook had a touch. And defense, it's... On we go to the AFC East, and we have to quote fellow New Englander James Taylor. The 1st of December and covered with snow. So was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. Dolphins, Patriots, this is how they got the field and the seats. Were the seats ready? Oh, my God, 2 feet of snow. Come on. Come on. All right, Dad, I'll be right with you. This is my seat. Remember 1982? The snowplow game.
and John Smith kicked a field goal as Mark Henderson on a work release program from the Walpole State Prison, and it was 3-0 New England on that day in 82. Who needs long johns? You can wear your shorts and clear the field. And so, as the field is cleared, here we go. Oh, man. Look at this field goal by Vinatieri. Do you think it was really good? Yes, it was.
Yes.
Just over the upright. The call stands. It's 3-0 Patriots very early. Second quarter. Jamie Nails blocking downfield. Helmet in half. Think it's cold? Oh, my God. The helmet's in half. He has to nail it together. He would return, obviously, new helmet. Ricky Williams hit in the backfield by Teddy Bruschi. Rodney Harrison finishes. You knew the feel of the moving the ball would be treacherous. Each team, Tom, had 11 punts. Now, later in the second, Mike Vrabel hits Ricky Williams in the backfield. So the Miami offense, which scored 40 on a perfect day in Thanksgiving in Dallas, struggling. Jay Fiedler, still third quarter, sack. Harrison, fumble. Mike Vrabel picks it up, Tom.
Yeah, when you look at Rodney Harrison and you see him around the line of scrimmage, you had better be alert and aware of where he is. He comes off the edge. They try to dual protect it, bring somebody out to him. No chance for him to get there. Turnover recovered by New England.
And this day, perfect for an ice-cold Bruschi. Teddy Bruschi picks off Fiedler. Touchdown, the four-yard pick, and the Patriots lead it 10-0, and that's the play that would seal it.
Watch the great play by Bruschi. He actually hides himself behind the line of scrimmage, squatted down, and I hope you understand what a great catch of the ball that was.
This is one of the most humorous scenes. After the touchdown, then they got a safety instead of fireworks. It's snowballs and snow showers, and the New England Patriots have won 9 in a row. They shut out the Dolphins 12-0. We told you each team punted 11 times. Hey, look, Tom Brady, we don't need you to get a touchdown this time, but we don't need any interceptions. Okay, coach, you want that? I can get you 38 points, or I can get you no picks. So the Dolphins turned over 3 times, the Patriots once. Mike Massaro with Ty Law.
Well, the New England Patriots are AFC East champions, and Ty Law, this had to be a big win for you guys. Where do you focus now?
We got one championship, but we got 2 more to go. I mean, now is the focus on, you know, continuing to win and put ourselves in good position for the playoffs.
You knew this was going to be a tough game. You had a bit of a hamstring pull. What happened there? How difficult was it to go back in?
I mean, it's always difficult, but the adrenaline was flowing, and I wanted to be back out there. I feel like we're a better team when I'm out there. The boys wanted me out there, so, I mean, I just did whatever I could. Of course, I couldn't play the proper technique, so I played off, but it worked out for me. I got an interception.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, Mike, thank you. The Patriots now at 11-2 control their own destiny for home field advantage throughout the playoffs. Mike Abel goes to special team Colts. 5-for-5 Vander Jag, who has 37 straight field goals dating back to last year. But more important, and we showed it to you, 3 fumbles forced, 3 fumbles recovered on the special teams. And every time it happened, it seemed it was a key moment of the game. Colts special teams get my game ball, Tom.
Yeah, and my game ball goes to Clinton Portis. A big day, big game in the AFC West. You look at